Okay, so here some of the parasites have some complex life cycles. Complex life cycle with that they are enhancing the ability to reach the two hosts at a time to infect the parasite and also improving their population. Sir, if you take Fasciola hepatica. Sir, one stage of Fasciola hepatica can reach two hosts. So, snail is there and sheep is there. And it also exhibits polyembryonic condition, sir. Fasciola hepatica has polyembryonic condition. So, in the polyembryonic condition, one zygote will develop into number of embryos and they will develop into the parasites. Okay. And it has a complex life cycle. If you take the parasite will go two hosts equally. In order to improve their population, the stages of parasites will go into two hosts at a time. So, with that, they have a scope to improve their population. That is a Fasciola hepatica. See, some of the parasites, in order to tide over the conditions of the host body, they undergo cystic form. Means, in order to tide over the conditions which present in the host body, so they undergo cystic stage. They undergo which stage? Cystic stage. Oh, example, if you take entamoeba. Sir, if you take entamoeba histolytica, will go for cystic stage whenever the host environment is not suitable. So, whenever the host environment is not suitable, the entamoeba will undergo cystation or cystic stage. So, in that stage, it will leave or it will face the situations created by the host. It will tide over. Next. Some of the enzymes are developing antigens against the host body, and some of the enzyme parasites are not at all killed by the vaccines because they are always changing their form. They are producing antigens against the host body response as well as they are changing their forms. For example, we are not able to develop vaccines or anything for the plasmodium and HIV virus. So, HIV virus also, it has been changing its form. So, that is why vaccines cannot be developed. So, plasmodium and HIV, they produce antigens against the host response. And also, they changes their form. So, in that way, we cannot produce vaccines to them. And they are living. This is one kind of adaptation. So, these are all the adaptations by the parasites. These are all parasitic adaptations. Development of anchoring structures, Huxu, Suckers, Rostellum, example Tinea solium. And they develop protective cuticle which will face the problem of enzymes of the host, Ascaris. Some of are producing anti-enzymes against the host enzymes. Against the host digestive enzymes, some of them are producing anti-enzymes, Tinea solium. Some of them are obligatory anaerobes, Entamoeba, Tinea solium, obligatory anaerobes. Facultative anaerobes, Ascaris is a facultative anaerobe. Facultative anaerobe means, when the oxygen is available, it will perform aerobic respiration. If oxygen is not available, it will perform anaerobic respiration. Obligatory means mandatory. So, 100% it will perform only anaerobic respiration. So, if you go to the another thing, so mitochondria are absent in that. So, that is why they cannot perform aerobic respiration. They only perform anaerobic respiration, sir. So, reproductive nature is improved. Enormous reproductive ability can be seen in the parasites. Ascaris, it lays 2 lakhs eggs per day. Tinea solium has 700 to 900 proglottids. Each proglottid is a reproductive unit. So, each proglottid produces 35,000 eggs. So, some of the parasites have complex life cycle. They improve their ability to reach the two hosts at a time. The example, Fasciola hepatica, it also exhibits polyembryonic condition. Some of the parasites undergoes cystic stages to tide over the conditions of the host. And some of the parasites are changing their forms. So, to escape from the host response and they are changing their forms. Okay. So, this is about the adaptations.